Hello children, welcome to the online class of science. As you know, we are learning about force, work and energy. This is chapter 11 and we are doing part 5. Right? We already learned about force and work in the previous parts. Today we are going to learn about energy. Yes? So, let us begin. What is energy? As you know, energy is the ability to do work. Okay, whatever work we do, okay, we learn, we play, we talk, we write, okay, everything needs energy. Even we need energy to push a car, to do other work. Okay, even a car needs energy, right? Needs energy in the form of fuel. We put petrol or diesel in the car to make it move, right? So energy of wind is used to make the trees sway. Okay, so everything we do needs energy. Even if we want to change the state of matter, like if you want to change water into water vapor, we need energy. Even cooking food, when we want to cook food, we need energy, right? Now this energy is found in different forms. Okay, there are different forms of energy that we use, like heat energy, light energy, electrical energy, okay, then wind energy, sun energy. Different forms of energy are there that we use. Right? So now let us start with the different forms of energy. So this is the heat energy. Heat energy we get by burning the fuels. Fuels means any type of fuel like wood, gas, petrol. All these when we burn, we get the heat. Okay? So this heat energy is used in various type of work. Even the sun energy heats the earth, right? See here, heat energy we use to cook the food, okay? We use the heat energy to cook the food. Without heat, we cannot cook any food, okay? Heat energy is also used to keep ourselves warm. See here, in the picture you can see the people have burned the wood so that they can keep themselves warm. Okay, heat energy is also required to keep the earth warm from the sun. The heat energy from the sun keeps the earth warm. Okay, so these are all the use of heat energy, right? Heat energy is also used in moving or running the train. Okay, the heat is produced by burning the coal, you know, so it helps to move the tree. Okay, nowadays we do not see these type of engines. Okay, but in the olden days we used to have this type of engines, and engines where we use the heat energy to run the tree. Okay, another type of energy, another form of energy is light energy. Okay, and as you know, we get light from various sources. Okay, from sun also we get light. Okay, in the daytime we get light. Okay, and plants use this energy of the sun, light energy of the sun, to make its food, as you very well know, in the process of photosynthesis. Here in the picture you can see the light energy. Okay, in the bulb here lights are glowing, so it gives the light. Even by burning a candle you get the light energy. Okay, see here it is shown that plants use the light energy of the sun to make the food in the process of photosynthesis, right? You have already learned this and now you know it very well. Yes, so this is another form of light energy. See, light energy from the sun. Because of the light energy of the sun, we are able to see in the daytime, right? And at night we have to make use of electricity, right? But in the daytime we are very, very well able to see the things because of the light energy from the sun. Yes, see here. So bulb also, the electric bulb also give us the light. Even this lamp, okay, by burning the fuel of oil. Okay, here oil is burned and the light is produced and we get the light energy, right? Another form of energy is electrical energy. Okay, the with the help of electricity we are able to run many gadgets in our home. Okay, so electricity, electrical energy, okay, you can call it, is the energy of electrical charges that produces the electricity, and with the help of that electricity we are able to run many gadgets and many things on in our day-to-day life. Even a train, as I told you, nowadays we do not run the train with the help of heat energy, we run it with the help of electrical energy, because now the engines are moving with the help of electricity. We call them electric engines, right? So here you see that the train is using the electrical energy. Yes, see here. Different types of gadget. This is a lift, okay, that is also you are running by the help of electric energy. Okay, then computers, fridge, TV, okay, all different types of your geyser, your washing machine, you know, a number of things are there that are operated with the help of electricity. Yes, we cannot, as you know now, the life has become difficult without electricity. So it is very important form of light, okay, important form of energy. Electrical energy is the important form of energy. Okay, see here, nowadays even a car, the vehicles are also running with the help of electricity. Here are the things that run, you know, even now car or even two wheelers are running with the help of electricity. See here, these are the toys, okay, very well known toys that children play. They all use the electrical energy. Okay, even small toys, all your remotes, they use the battery. Okay, so that is also electrical energy, you can say. And these are all the different toys that use the electric energy. Okay, so now we'll discuss about the sources of energy. Okay, sun, wind, water and fuels are the main sources of energy. See, the energy from the sun is called solar energy, and the sun is our main source of energy. As you know, because of the sun's energy, the earth gets heat, right? And also the light. We are able to see in the daytime because of the sunlight, right? This sunlight is also very important for plants, so that they can make food in the process of photosynthesis, right? That we have already learned. The energy we get from sun is also called solar energy, and this solar energy is also very useful to us, right? This solar energy is used to heat up the solar panels, and the electricity produced by solar panels can be used as in the solar heaters, right? And this also is very useful for us. Also, solar cookers are also there nowadays. It has been used since long. Solar cookers are the device with which we can cook our food with the help of solar energy, right? So that so that we can have the energy at the cheaper cost, right? So we can say that solar energy is very useful. Now the energy from the wind, you know, the moving air is called wind, and this wind is used to generate electricity with the help of device called windmills, right? The windmills are installed in the place where the fast wind blow. Okay, so with the help of that wind, the turbines, you can say these turbines, they rotate, and in this process they produce electricity, and this electrical energy, we can use in various aspects, right? Wind energy is also used to sail small ships, right? Because with the help of wind energy, these ships can sail in that direction, right? See, paragliders also use wind energy to fly in the sky. See, you can see in the picture. Because of the help, with the help of wind energy, they are able to fly in the sky. Wind energy is also used in some sports like kite flying. You know, kite flying festival is also there. Yeah, at the time of Uttarayan, the people, they fly kite. In that also wind energy, you can say wind energy is used. With the help of wind only, the kites are able to fly in the sky, right? Now, energy from water. Okay, water is also used to generate electricity. Okay, we can also generate electricity from the water. Water, you know, you can see in the picture, dams are built. How water is used? So dams are built to allow the water to fall from a height onto the machines, and these machines help to generate electricity, right? So you can say that water is also important to, or can be used to produce the electricity, right? Now I hope you have understood the sources of energy and also what are the different forms of energy. Here I take your leave and I end this session. Thank you.